we have a stick. Break pots. Let me see if I can move my Twitch chat. 1 second. It looks like it does not let me, it looks like it pauses while I'm moving. Where's my unlock button here? One second. Why is it not letting me move this around? Am I locked for some reason? Ah, I am locked. 1 second. Here's the Twitch chat. There it is. There we go. Alright, back to the game. Not know what I just did. I'm guessing it's a save or something. Something. I don't know. Ooh, pretty. Some sort of ghost body I'm in, I'm guessing. Very pretty, though. I wonder why Twitch chat isn't picking up. Okay, that worked. Huh, weird. What is this? So someone is imprisoned, but are they good or bad? We do not know. suppose we will find out. We have a key of some kind. So I can't go farther from here without something I can cut with. So maybe I can go back and see if that key I just got unlocks the door back here. Okay, this is a cute way to present the game. Is as if it's pages of an old manual. And of course, the treasure back here is already taken. Another piece of the manual. Alright, so right trigger to get a shield once I get one. Potions, etc. Actually, wait a minute. I saw something in there about something in holding. It's just holding the direction, I think. Because it doesn't dodge if you just stand still. If I go down that way, I can't go back up, so I'll explore the other direction first. Doesn't look like anything I can do up here, though. Yet. The stair up is blocked by this block here. That sure does look like the character that was in prison, that we saw in prison, though. Safe spot, I'm guessing. And more chests that have already been looted. These guys are fairly sturdy. Oh, and they shoot back. I don't know what that message is. I don't know what to do there. Can I slip through here? Doesn't look like it. Not yet, anyways. I can come back here, though. And open this chest. Alright, so we've got more slimes coming up, and then some big kobold-y guys. Can I go down here? Doesn't look like it. Grave with the sword icon that way. Maybe I don't want to fight all those things quite yet. We have a safe spot. That's only a little foreboding. We have a hidden chest over here. Well, not that hidden. Some kind of berry. Can I eat it? Looks like those are consumables. So I kind of don't want to use them yet unless I have to, or at least until I figure out what they do. Oh wow, you can actually zoom in and see the fake dot patterns on it. Cute. I suppose I should look and see what the backside of this page is. Explaining where your iframes are. That's good to know. Pretty. Ooh, and there's something down there that eventually I will be able to go and see. Hero's grave this way. Ooh, that's actually a lot of damage. Thank you. maybe I do want to take a... try one of those items to see if it's a, health item. Yep, it is a health item. Res me, Fox God thing. All right, so resurrected. But I do no longer have that health pot yet. So now the fight's going to be a little bit harder. You pretty much only get one hit on those before you need to dodge. I instantly die again. Did I see right that he killed the big guy for me? Because that's convenient. Sad Hero Fox. I will take your sword. Here lies the hero. That's where I'm gonna end up. Alright, now I can chop through bushes, which opens up a bunch of the world to me, and probably lets me do a bit more damage. But it also means that the hero gets no foliage around his grave. That's just how it's gotta be. Thank you. Yeah, buddy, I'm not fighting you right now. I'm gonna go save first. And get my health back. Now I will go back and fight that blob. Oh yeah, that's a lot more damage than I used to deal. I wonder if I'm gonna get a jump move to be able to go up here eventually. Beheaded fox statue, that's foreboding. Oh yeah, I'm doing a lot more damage per swing now. Yeah, I'm guessing there's gonna be a jump move I get eventually to jump across this gap. Yep, I am trying rolling. It just brings me to a stop right there at the gap. The roll button actually also doubles as a dash button here. Actually, I wonder if I can dash the gap. Come up here and give it a try. Nope, it comes to a stop here. Unless there's something back here that I can wander through to get there. Doesn't look like it. Not now, at least. Either that or I'm looping around from up there. Let's find out. Now I should be able to climb up here. Some way to get up on top of this building, apparently, I'm guessing. Then from there I'll be able to run over and get it. Is there a closed door? The faint perspective shifts when you walk onto an enemy are nice, but also a little annoying. Because it's a pretty dramatic angle change. Alright, lever, that probably opens the door right below me. Upstairs of that guardhouse. The one that I took a peek at and then immediately left. Guessing that's a heart piece. Don't know. Yeah, it is. I just saw the one out of three. Here's another hidden chest sort of in the corner. I one-shot those now with the sword instead of using the stick. That almost seems like cheating. made such a cute squeak. Wait, big fancy chest in sunlight. My first heal pot. I think I remember that from the demo. Anything back here that I can go to? Nope. Go save, and then I will go up and... Oh, hello? Are so cute and squeaky, I feel bad killing them. Gee, was that a chest down here? I think we have a boss fight here. That's first. Ooh. We got some combos. Ooh boy, he hits hard. Really damn hard. Another heal pot. But it doesn't look like I can... Oh, there it is. Legendary heroes, Bane of Pots. Nothing to interact with back in that corner. Ooh, pretty tile work. That's always a good sign. Okay, so you can break these already. Times, it seems to say. climb down. Can I climb back up it? Yes, I can. Wonder if Fox Lady has any change now that the bell is active. Doesn't look like it. Is there anything else I could do down here? I don't remember. No, it doesn't look like it. Unless I can cut my way through here to make a path I couldn't get to before. And no, I was able to get through here before, so this is nothing new, at least it looks like. I wonder if I'll get a fishing rod or something to let me get through there later. To do something there later, I should say. Anything hidden back here? Nope. I do notice that nearly all the enemies are gone, though. Well, oh, but I haven't died since I did that, so I guess they wouldn't have respawned. Had any reason to respawn. Oh, I don't think I'm supposed to be up here yet. I will cut you all back down here, though. Ooh, that nearly killed me. Okay, I'm running. Well, maybe I'll pull. Or at least I will heal and save before I try that again. Rat guy only attacks when I come near him. I might just ignore him for a second and run past him, because up here, I think, is how I get to these two chests. Or at least to one of them. Some kind of bomb, it looks like. Looks like it does not let me get to this chest, though. That is accessible some other way. If I had to guess, I'd say there's probably... I don't have a mouse cursor, but there's probably a hidden pathway somewhere behind one of these trees that clips through this wall and lets me get there. Well, good to know. I will come back here when I have some sort... When I have bombs that I actually trust. Okay, he can one-shot me. Or close to one-shot me anyways. So squeaky. I wonder if I have to fight that boss again. Nope. Just one little bubble guy here. Alrighty, now we run out here. back to where the bell was. And down. We'll move on. Alright, you're back in the starting zone, which I'm guessing is some kind of hub. I see another piece of manual, so... let's chop our way through the manual, over here to the manual piece. Aha, here's the full overworld. Ah. So you're under the well. Save point here. Okay. Now that I can cut through there, I can do that and open up this thing. Another heart container. So if you are low on stamina, you actually take more damage, and you can get knocked over. That's good to know. Don't know what that is. I mean, it's a tuning fork of some kind, but we don't know what it does yet. Ooh, that big old burst of damage. Shot or something that eventually is going to let me get that piece of manual. Okay. stairway down there in the corner. I remember those from the demo. Take a health pot. Another of those fox helmets, whatever they're for. Okay, I see. I'm guessing that is what you hookshot to. I noticed there's another chest down there. I kind of don't want to try to fight that guy yet. Let's see what's down here. Money. Fairy Fountain, yeah. How you doing, Scott? Long time no see. We have an ominously dim room here. A couple chests still available. Bombs. Or something. It's going to be interesting to try and figure out what all these items do. I need to get more manual pages. This game does kind of scratch that old NES itch of not understanding what to do with items and having to figure it out. See a chest. An ominous looking skull. Actually, let me look at what inventory I have here. I don't know what any of those are yet. run up the middle here. Is there a... Ah, there is something hidden back here. Maybe. I do not know what to do here. I'll come back. I'm sure I'll find out eventually. There's anything I can find here yet. Kind of just need to get a save point and then probably move on a bit. Let's see here, because where's that map? Old house, flooded well, dark tomb. So I need the key. I love this fake screen printing. I wonder what the little, I noticed the little note there, so I wonder if there's something you need to ring there. This is cute. Ah, there's a safe spot. Like something I can't open yet. Ooh, a shield. Alright, so... Okay, I'm guessing this is the exit for whatever that dungeon that is that gets me the shield. What happens if I run over here? Is there something back here I can... chest. Another mystery item. At some point I might just need to start trying out some of those random items and see what they do. I'm guessing that is that dark tomb area that I saw on the map mentioned. Try to get the key to the house again, because I don't think I'm supposed to be here quite yet. But that's half the fun of it. Oh, those are hostages. Hostiles with a really disturbing attack. Thank you. with that. He really wants to fight. I wonder how you get that. That one. I'm sure I'll find out eventually. Potentially hidden area anyways. Oh, that's ominous. That is really ominous. Camera shifts here makes me think I'm supposed to do something here, but I'm not sure what. Wait until the turret goes back down. That's a skull. If I don't have the shield, I probably can't get through here alive because of how slow the water prevents you from dodging or rolling. Alrighty, we'll come back here later. Way to get back there. probably down this ladder. So I need to figure out some way to get this guy in order to get the key. So you can attack, you can dodge his initial attack, hit him, and then dodge again. That thing. Ah, vendor. And some bombs. That is impressively creepy. Thank you. how, what the, how big of a leash there is on these guys. The answer it seems is that there's very long leashes on everything. Just past that turret is that chest. I could probably run past the turret and get to the chest, but if I can get a shield up here, that's even better. I still don't quite have the timing on the on dodging those. The old house. Okay, here's the shield. Yeah, this is a super cute game so far. I definitely see why people complain about the difficulty having weird spikes here and there. But so far it's really cute. The models have almost like a papercraft quality to them. Business, I think, is actually to go save. A page between the nightstand and bed. I didn't see it, but I'll go look. I think that's just part of the bed geometry. I don't have any move I can use to bump it or to get on top of the bed. I don't know. You have a really short stamina on the shield. Nice. It looks like there's a parry mechanic if you tap a shield at exactly... Yeah, shield... No, a shield bash. Show up on my inventory screen. Oh, maybe it does. I don't know what that does, but I suppose I'll find out soon enough. Let's see if I can get through here now that I have the shield. Definitely cannot just brawl that. Ignore everyone here and run past them to get back. It is salty run back o'clock. Down. Almost got it. I probably should have just used a heal potion. How much have I lost? Not that much. Once again, run past everything. That actually looks like, almost looks like a map, but maybe not. Some kind of time of hourglass thing. Looks like a reusable weapon. Ah, yeah, lets me slow down time for a little bit. That could be really useful. Like it's fades, it fades as soon as I take damage, though. Also, I am now nearly dead with no health pots. Oh my god, it's so cute. What is that? Some sort of consumable item, it looks like. It looks like I can't get over there yet. What does it feel like? Something's guaranteed to be stuck about hidden back here. Actually, I will be right back, sorry. I need to use the restroom for a second. Thank you. All right, I am back. Doesn't look like there's anything else hidden back here for now. It killed me. Well, at least it's a fast run back. Okay, mental note. Being able to slow down time does not save me at all. I think I got back down here the last time by coming behind the windmill? Yeah. Here's that creepy spot. The vague sensation that someone went to a lot of expense to imprison that god creature. Maybe I ought to keep my eyes open. Alright, I'm gonna save here and refill my HP bar. I really wish I had more, there was a way to get more stamina, but I'm sure that might come at some later point. Well, now that I have a shield, let's go see about that dark tomb area. Behind the waterfall. What's back here? Don't know what's back here. Might have to come back later for that once I figure it out. I'm guessing there's a path or something up here that will eventually get cleared out. Thank you. just a little too slow on that. That was dumb of me. I could have actually stepped back and just taken a health pot. Oh well. It'll be a fast run back. Being picked up whenever I destroy one of those things, and don't know what that's used for yet. And we have a manual page. So apparently I can turn these in at a safe spot to get some permanent buffs? Three attack, three defense, it says. I can't see what my current values are from here, it looks like. Well, now I'm gonna run back and actually try that. How do I do it? Ah. Gotcha. I wonder if it's going to start replacing some of the words with English words as you go. Okay, so now I have more HP. I'll actually get even more HP, because I'm bad at games. I bet you this will be the same dungeon as as the in the demo. Upgrade for HP. I might actually go back and immediately turn in that item, but actually I should be able to do it here. No, I don't know if I have enough points. Let's find out. No, I don't. But I'm close, actually. I only need another 50. I can probably make that just farming enemies in here if I need to. Explosion took out him too. Piece of the manual. Ooh, this is a big game. I dig it. My interests right now. I remember, now I'm remembering the salty runbacks from the boss for this area, because I remember the boss for this area sucks. Remember, the music slaps. I don't know what the potion upgrade actually does for me, but I'm guessing just makes the potions restore more HP, because they don't by default. They just give you little tiny top-offs. Something over here. Doesn't look like it. That's what those blue dots are. That's refilling my mana bar, I'm guessing. What, if anything, is down here? Nothing, I guess. Kill this guy and get the way back from the spawn unlocked. Chests. Yeah, the tentacles. I forgot about these. Really gotten myself killed for 20 coins. I'll go ahead and take my chance here. And that might get me killed. Nope, I survived. Nope, I got greedy. That's a long loading screen. At least I can run back pretty quickly to get my lost gold. Gross. can I remember how to get to the boss? That's something I can offer to get a defense. I will definitely go back and do that. Actually, how much do I have? 100. I can afford that. Refilled and wait through the very long loading screen. Like there's something up here. Oh, there it is. I remember that fight used to give me a lot of trouble in the demo. This ladder up, by the way. What's in here? Oh, that's the alternate. It's telling me I don't. This is basically the call out that, oh, you don't have the lantern. Straight past these guys. And loading screen. And I'm guessing this is the actual intended boss. I'm out here. Here's the lantern I need. It looks like it's just automatic use once you have it. I wonder if there's a way for me to get out here and explore a little. Doesn't look like it, though. So let's see what this area looks like with a lantern. Ah, gotcha. Well, in that case, I'm going to run back here and... Because I remember the scene on the map that there was a... Wait, is it showing me my spot on the map? Yes, it is. It's actually drawing my character's location on the map. That's interesting. Yeah, it says it has a question mark there to imply there's something down there. Let's actually get in the water and see if I can go over the waterfall now that I have the item I need from this area. Start by knocking out that goblin. Let me go over. It will not. Or it could honestly be that icon isn't marking a secret, it's just something else. Still haven't figured out how to get to that treasure chest. Oh, I see a way you can get there on the map. At least a way. It insinuates that there's a hole back here. Yeah, it looks like this is some sort of secret. I wonder if I've got a bomb-like item. Let's find out. That didn't do it. Maybe this is a little bit beefier. I put myself out of fire. There it goes. I'm gonna take that off my inventory for the time being. Yeah, this definitely looks like some sort of used to. Oh, there you go. Container. Rather, potion, I guess. And then I bet you I can run over this over here. Yep, and get this chest. I wonder what those big coins are used for. Now that I have a lantern. I can run past these guys because I know they don't. Oh, they will follow me. Not up here. Go back down and save. Now I can get around, look around back there, but it's not anything to find there. Alrighty, so now that I have the lantern, let's go back up into the tomb. Remember there was a... Yeah, here we are. I have to admit, I really do love the Baltic pen drawings on it. Shifting perspective whenever you lock onto a target is a little annoying, honestly. Something new on the card thing. I haven't figured out 100% what the card thing does. I think it gives you a chance for something extra to spawn from each enemy kill. Because I put on the heart card and it was dropping hearts earlier. Or at least that's when enemies started dropping hearts. I think that's everything in here for now. Downstairs we go. So I should probably drink a health potion since I'm already on half health. Drink all the pots, because that's kind of what you do. Alright, looks like I have to go around and down. That the spike traps would kill them. I aggro these guys and have them kill it. But I can go around here. I wonder if those spikes are instant death. I kind of don't want to try and find out. No, this was the way I came. But I'll check. Yeah, this was the way I came. Here. And these are the laser switches. Alright, so I can lock these over. But it seems that the map seems to simulate that I don't want to. I don't know what I was, what the map is referring to with having one, a circle around one of the statues, though. I can always come back and find out. That's the defense item. And now I'm back on the outer world. Ah, I remember getting here was where the original demo ended. Is there anything back here? I can get behind the statue, but it doesn't look like there's anything back here for me to grab. There's a land bridge over here, though. We haven't figured out how to open those doors yet. Chest we can't get to yet. And a safe spot. Alright, folks. Since we just got to a safe spot, and it's been about 2 hours of streaming this, since I started late, I'm gonna call it here for now. I think I'm gonna pick this up tomorrow morning, because this is really, really fun and cute. I like it. So, if you want to watch more of this, feel free to come in tomorrow. Hope you all enjoyed watching this, and I will see you later.